ladies and gentlemen.
I'm an agent of chaos. Oh, and you know the thing about chaos? It's fair.
I'm a man of my word.
Introduce a little anarchy. Upset the established order, and everything becomes chaos.
See, the Tyrannosaur doesn't obey any set patterns or park schedules. It's the essence of chaos.
I'm still not clear on chaos.
It simply deals with predictability in complex systems. The shorthand is the butterfly effect. A butterfly can flap its wings in Peking, and in Central Park you get rain instead of sunshine.
Why?
And did I go too fast? I go too fast. I did a flyby. No.
Give me that glass of water. We're going to conduct an experiment. It should be still. The car's bouncing up and down, but that's okay. It's just an example. Now, put your hand flat like a hieroglyphic. Then, now, let's say a drop waterfalls in your hand. Which way is the drop going to roll off? Over which finger, or over the thumb, or the other side?
Thumb. Let's say.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Right.
Okay, now freeze your hand. Don't move. I'm going to do the same thing. Start with the same place again. Right. Which way is it going to roll off?
Let's say back. Nope. Same way.
Same back. It changed. Why? Because tiny variations, the orientation of the hairs on your hands.
Hey, Alan, look at this.
The amount of blood distending your vessels, imperfections in the skin.
Microscopic.
And never repeat and vastly affect the outcome. That's
what? Unpredictability.
Researchers have used mathematical models based on chaos theory to analyze the movements of a pod of satellite-tagged narwhals.
And the betrayal was revealed, and you're divorced and you set yourself up. In 2 years, you might be in a better place than you were. I'm just saying that it's more complicated than it looks. That's the introduction of chaos into order. The oldest story we have is something like, order is susceptible to disruption by chaos.
Say yes to win!
Hey, Pinhead!
You work the fairy.
Yeah, so?
Say yes to chance!
Would you like to try something different?
Say yes to chaos!
Chaos theory.
You're a crappy person. Leading a crappy life. Crappy.
No.
Yeah, crappy.
Thank you.
hell has a lot to do with the Underdark. Forgotten Realms describes Shadowfell, similar to the Shadowlands of Warcraft lore. According to this lore, every such type of region has a bordering ethereal curtain of a certain color. In case of Shadowfell, this color is silver, and you should see why. It's because Shadowfell is connected with the Underdark, which was born during the times of Helios, when silver had a greater role than gold. As we have seen before, the number 8 stands for chaos, and by extension for the skies and seas of infinity, and thus the abyss, which can be seen as a sort of tested by fire political skeleton for the Shadowlands and for chaos. So we should be talking about the jersey number 8. The more general number 8 network in the chaos is often deceived or numbed by deep time.
Like that frog. Oh, that frog in the miniskirt putting a quarter in the jukebox.
Bingo.
I'm concerned that frog's in more trouble than she realizes.
In Shadowfell, one can find the domains of Dread, which do not recognize the rule of Shar, the goddess of the dark. The domains of Dread are ruled by the dark powers, of whom one of the most important seems to be Hazlek, who should be seen more as a stereotype.
Thank you.
According to the lore, in his rise to power, Hazlik became an enemy of the necromancer Thantosia and coveted her lover, Ordia. Baphomet is a bit of a contradiction, although the closeness to the Univeaver makes Baphomet seem to be a bit of a devil. Baphomet is classified as a demon lord.
Rocky, please don't go to Mars and fight the Martian.
I gotta do what I gotta do.
But there's no oxygen on Mars.
Yeah? That means there's no oxygen for him either. That Martian wants a fight, he'll get a fight.
You can't win, Rock! You're 60 years old!
Hey, look what Rocky bought me with his money!
Look, I'm sorry. I can't have you in here punching the meat. I mean, there's really not too many things you can't do in here, but that is one of them.
What about Pauly? He's having sex with the meat.
Hey, Rock, I'm porking it.
That's a good one.
Pale Knight had to crawl through Baphomet's endless maze to access Pale Knight's other domain, the delirious realm of Androlin. Obviously, Androlin is an outpost friendly to females, closer to the surface than the Underdark, which was later upheld by mortals, thus Andro and lions, it might appear. palace lost in Baphomet's maze, Wonderland, where usual Shakespearean liar, the Mad Hatter, could doctor the narrator, portray good as evil and vice versa.
William Shakespeare!
Aye.
Nice collar, you fruit!
Thank ye.
Hey, Shakespeare, what's the title of your next play? You should call it Homosexual Collar Guy.
Ah, thy japes and jabs cut me to the quick, squire.
What does that even mean?
I know. It means I use this collar as a bib for when I service guys.
Thank ye, thank ye. So, how'd you like the collar?
'Tis not for me.
We now return to The Last Man on Earth, plus these other 16 people, with more showing up every day.
No way they'll pull this off. A show with just one character and an unlimited number of other characters?
Peter, you can't just sit there and watch TV all day. You have to mow the lawn.
This sucks. I was gonna go down to the Guitar Center and annoy people. FYI, my mom's not picking me up for a long time because... she's dead! Hey, Brian, you want a beer?
Peter, Lois is gonna be home soon. Shouldn't you be mowing the lawn?
I am mowing the lawn.
Where'd you get these?
Craigslist. Boy, that's gotta be some long list.
And pool tables and jukeboxes. Craig, are you getting all this down?
Yes. Is that it?
No! Futons, everyone's grandfather's golf clubs.
Is that it?
No! Gay sex!
What kind?
All of it!
I have milked all the goats.
Peter, all those goats are males.
Well, the buckets are full and the goats are happy. I just hope word doesn't get around.
I like good times.
We now return to Top Gun with only public domain music.
She'll be coming round the mountain when she comes.
Oh boy, Amber Alert. Stewie was last seen with a goat in a 98 Toyota Tercel heading north on I-95.
She'll be coming round the mountain.
Oh, my God, what the hell did the goats do in here? This place is disgusting. Where's your father? Peter!
Lois is mad. Go to the clam.
Peter, I both saw you and recognized my husband's voice.
Go back!
Enough. My parents will be here any minute.
Darling, so wonderful to be here.
Yeah, right. The drive here is like a counterclockwise trip around the Monopoly board.
He has no pants.
Peter, get out of there.
Lois, what's going on here?
Well, I asked Peter to mow the lawn. Will somebody turn off Top Gun? So obviously, he bought a herd of goats, and now they've taken over the house.
Lois, I worry this is not a healthy environment for the children.
Mom, please. You know I would never put my children in harm's way.
Lois, I've seen enough. You're completely overwhelmed, and you have four children.
Four children.
I'm sorry, Jesus, but my house, my rules.
Up yours, Joseph! You're not my real dad!
Hello?
Hey, Dad. It's me. Listen, things here aren't working out anymore, and I was wondering, can I come live with you and Janet for a while?
Oh, wow, kiddo. You know, I'd love that, but I don't know if now is the best time. Maybe next year, okay? I'll see you Friday night. Tell your mother I sent the check. So where were we?
Right about here.
Ah, come on, baby. It's my birthday.
No.
Hey!
Hey.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey there.
Hey, nice spot, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's great, especially because of that thing over there. You know what's in there? Corn. Really? Wow, I could go for some corn.
You're dark, Raj.
I don't care.
Let's see, shirt, pants, hey, I'm missing another shark. Hey!
Welcome to Narnia, I'm Mr. Tumnus.
Hey, give me back my shark, you goat bastard! Hey!
What you want? What you want for Christmas?
I was thinking maybe one of those old-timey...
Too late! Take too long! Sad Christmas! What you want?
Fire truck!
What color?
Red!
Next!
Ah! All right, men, this is a dangerous mission, and it's likely one of us will be killed. The landing party will consist of myself, Mr. Spock, Dr. McCoy, and Ensign Ricky.
Ah, crap.
For God's sake, Peter, you've been sitting in front of the TV since you got home from work. Why don't you spend some time with your family?
I will. I'm just gonna do it during the commercials.
We now return to Star Trek.
Holy crap, Uhura's black?
Dude, you gotta introduce me to that black chick.
I heard that there was a Romulan ship spotted in our sector, which means...
Hey! Hey!
All right, I'm gonna have to do the Vulcan V-meld.
We now return to Star Trek II, The Wrath of Khan, edited for GOATS.
Marooned for all eternity in the center of a dead planet. Buried alive. Buried alive.
Ah, she saw us! Warp speed!
Ah, yes! You're damn right! Hell yeah! You can suck it!
Come on!
obviously then the number 8 jersey has both good and bad. For example, Karn, the betrayer. Although some such are no betrayers of good, although the bad number 8 will accuse such a good number 8, even a good Karn, of being evil. That's the problem for the good H, for the good number 8 in the chaos. Some of the things that we take for granted in order, such as protection against some of the more organized types of injustice, cannot always be taken for granted by the good number 8, who must contend with a negative bias from the evil entrenched in order, which has all but tried to claim that evil is a synonym for chaos. And this was so especially after the sundering, which is why number 8, or H, is seen in some dogmas as insignificant, which also happens to have a deep link with how 9, or rather the symbol I, stands for unreal numbers in mathematics.
On the 11th of February 1951, two centurions, under the command of Captain Strachan, spotted an armoured vehicle hiding under the right side of the Han River railway bridge. In what would prove to be a record distance shot at the time, a centurion fired an armour-piercing round at 3,000 yards, or 1.7 miles, hitting the unidentified tank. Strachan and his companion Centurion moved forward to investigate and were surprised to discover that the mystery tank wasn't a T-34, but a British Cromwell belonging to the 8th Hussars. It is perhaps ironic that the first ever tank kill achieved by this superb Centurion was against a British tank. Even more ironic, the Cromwell was from the same regiment as the Centurions, the 8th King's Royal Irish Hussars.
Thank you.
The fact is that energy sinks infest all sides. So the academic ideas of a conflict between races, religions, even ideologies, or nations, in this case Ukraine and Russia, does not translate to reality.
Commander Wolf's head looks like a fanny.
You can both suck my ridges.
Oh, get a sense of humor, Rocky Dennis.
Thank you.
not very far from Ukraine, we see another component of this natural diplomatic system I'm talking about, which can also be played, which can also be cheated for profit. Sinks try to dominate this system by digging into the Donbass sector. This natural diplomatic system interfaces in this way into the wider network of donors. So the Sinks get a lot of global power from infesting the Donbass. They could claim to be the true friends of animals, dominate society, dominate the WWF and the UN, for example. Now we can also have a look at the politics of nature manipulation at a place other than Ukraine.